Hey everybody, what's going on? Welcome back to the 25 Days of Linux. I bought a whiskey barrel. Check it out! I don't want to pick it up, it's really heavy. So today I wanted to take a look at Ubuntu. I'm not really someone who does a ton of distribution reviews. The reason for that is mostly because, I don't know, it seems kind of pointless. I think really the last thing I'm worried about in terms of Linux is what distribution I'm using. I typically stick with Arch Linux. That's just because of the AUR. And when I have made videos about other Linux distributions, which I've basically just done about Void Linux and Solus Linux, they're really about something else. The Void Linux video was about XBPS, I think. And the video I did about Solus was really just a video about Budgie, which I think is cool. And that's also what I've got here. I've got Ubuntu's community version of Budgie, which is, I think, just basically the same as normal Ubuntu that you get with GNOME or whatever they ship it with. I forget. But it comes with Budgie. I actually can open up the Budgie settings or the Budgie desktop settings and do the same things I can normally do in Budgie. If I don't like this panel that they've built up here or this little dock thing that they've built that for some reason just wants to stick right here, I can change all of that. But actually, I'm really not interested in that. What I'm interested in doing is taking a look at how difficult it would be for me to get Ubuntu set up with a window manager the way that I want to use it. I've been thinking about switching to Ubuntu recently, but before I do that, I should probably test drive it and see if it's gonna just make me want to tear my hair out. As far as the reason that I would want to switch to Ubuntu over Arch Linux, Arch Linux is great. The AUR is mainly what makes it awesome. Pac-Man is, of course, fine on its own. There's nothing wrong with Pac-Man, but you know, access to software, even this like super new stuff that doesn't have official packages in a lot of the repositories, is pretty much immediately available on Arch, and that's an awesome advantage to have. The one disadvantage that I have noticed is sort of stability, and I think people will point that out a lot, but I noticed it when I was maintaining servers. I have really just one server that I have in my house at this point, and it's just a Plex server, and I ran that on Arch for quite a while, but it just sort of became a pain. If you don't keep Arch up to date, can be kind of hard to update it after you haven't done it in a long time. It's just like stuff likes to break because it is a rolling release distribution. It's not really built to just be super stable over long periods of time, whether you update it or not. Ubuntu, especially the Ubuntu flavors that come with the LTS kernel, are. And I don't actually think this is shipped with the LTS kernel. Like I said, this is a community flavor. It's the Budgie version. But I mean, presumably if I was going to run Ubuntu, I'd try to get like the minimal installer. I think they still do that. And even if it didn't come with the LTS kernel, you can swap Linux kernels, I believe, not horribly difficultly. We'll find out. But like I said, I want to try to get a little bit of a window manager set up here. So we'll go ahead and do sudo apt install. And I'm hoping they have awesome. And yeah, looks good. Cool. So I'm actually going to go ahead and log out of Ubuntu here, or Budgie at least. Should be able to do that there. And we're just using, what do you call it, LightDM here. So this is going to be real small for a second, but I should be able to come over here, switch over to the Awesome Window Manager, put my password back in, and we're in Awesome. So now as far as getting things set up, I just need to sort of install the programs that I would normally use. So I'm normally a big fan of Alacrity, which is not here by default. So first challenge, we're already into it. I thought it might have taken a little bit longer to hit a challenge, but you know, hey, Alacrity is a fairly new terminal, sort of cutting edge or whatever. I don't know. How to install Alacrity on Ubuntu. How to install Alacrity Terminal Emulator on Linux. Geeksforgeeks.org, don't let me down here, boys. Sudo apt repository. Oh, so I just have to add the repository, it looks like, and then I should be good to do it. All right, cool. I've encountered that a few times on my various misadventures with Alacrity. So then what can I do? Sudo apt install Alacrity. Looks good. All right, nice. Okay, so then we go ahead and try to open up Alacrity, and nothing happens. Let's try sudo apt install dmenu as well. See if there is a dmenu package. There is. Nice. All right, cool. That's always handy. Of course, if you're using a Cyclos app, you're really meant to build it on your own. But I don't mind in this sort of case when I'm trying something else just to run dmenu run. So then we'll go ahead and try to relaunch Alacrity. And we're having an issue initializing the shaders. Okay, yeah, that's cool. Like I said, Alacrity sometimes just fails to launch in VMs for me sometimes. I don't think that is a Ubuntu issue, so we're going to ignore that. But for whatever reason, also Kitty wasn't working. But that's also a GPU accelerated terminal. What's one that's not? Is Termite available? Or Xterm, right? Sudo apt install Xterm. That's not GPU accelerated at all. Xterm. Hey, look at that. We got another terminal. Xterm is pretty easy to customize the same way that a lot of other ones are. So that's nice. We could go ahead and set a wallpaper here. To do that, we're probably going to need an app. So we'll do sudo apt install and see if they have Nitrogen. That's a pretty good little wallpaper setter. And then we can go ahead and run Nitrogen. And it's going to ask us to add a... what do you call it, a repository for the wallpapers. So we'll just add our downloads folder, and then we'll set it to set the screen one, and set it to zoomed fill. All right, now it is a 25 days of Linux video officially. Nice. All right, cool. So what else do we need? We're probably going to need a Polybar. Polybar is like my favorite app in the world, and if this doesn't work, there's zero chance I'm ever going to use Ubuntu. But it's there. I'm so shocked by that, because for some reason Polybar actually isn't even available in Pac-Man. You have to go and get it through the AUR, but it's right here in Ubuntu. Very nice. I actually did download my .dot file, so all I should have to do is cd into my config folder, and yeah, that doesn't have too much in there. I can probably wipe that out. Maybe I'll move .dot config to config backup, just in case I break anything really badly. But then we can go ahead and link my documents dot config right here. So then all I should have to do is run one of my Polybar scripts. So I can go into config slash Polybar slash big shell script, and we have a Polybar. And actually it looks kind of good. So the only thing that's not showing up right now are the icons, which that's easy enough to fix. I just need to install a nerd font to do it. But you can see the host name program that I use is working. All the volume icons and disk space usage things seem to be working perfectly fine. All that kind of stuff is good to go. I can scroll up the volume here really easily. We're pretty well set up and ready to rock. I could also go ahead and kill Polybar, and then I should be able to do control command R. And now we have awesome window manager using my config. So that's nice. That's a good step in the right direction there. And if I were to pop this out of tiling mode, you can see I've got gaps and everything all set up. So that's nice. I guess we could go ahead and try to fix the font issue. Let's go to nerdfonts.com. I'm pretty sure that's the web address. Apparently not, though. That would have been great. And we should be able to just go to fonts download, and let's search for the hack. Oh, that's right. These are images, not text. So you have to actually scroll and find the nerd font that you want. Okay, so here it is. Hack nerd font. We download that bad boy right there. Save file. So makedir.fonts. CD over into downloads. LS. We unzip hack.zip. And let's open up Ranger here. And we need all of these fonts. So we will copy them all. D lowercase d will cut. And then we can do pp to paste. Nice. And then we have to run a command to rebuild the font cache. There it is right there. Control shift v, control command r to reload. Awesome. And we have icons. Nice. What else do we need here? PyCom never works for me in virtual machines. Is again, it's an issue with the way that I configure the virtual machines, but hey, what the hell, we'll give it a shot here. Just to see if it's in the default Ubuntu repository. So sudo apt install PyCom. I usually install a fork of PyCom, so I'm anticipating if I do switch to Ubuntu having to manually build that, but whatever. So we can go ahead and try to run PyCom again, and nothing's really happening. Fatal error. I'm assuming it's still just not going to run. Yeah, okay, that's fine. It is right there in the repository, so that wouldn't be too big of a hassle to get through. And it seems like really most of the sort of hurdles that I'm hitting are being more an issue with the VM than the actual OS itself or the package manager that Ubuntu uses apt. So actually, I don't think this would be that bad of an experience. There's a few weird things, like let me do sudo apt install OBS. OBS isn't there, but it might also be under OBS Studio or something like that. Yep, looks like it is. So install NeoVim. That looks good as well. One interesting thing here is changing the GTK app themes. What I could do is sudo apt install, see if they have LX appearance is the name of one of the apps that I use a lot. They do, so that's cool. We could go ahead and try to run LX appearance, and hey, look at that. Let me find a sort of dark theme here. Go ahead and apply it, close, and we could exit this app, open it back up again. What was it? Tilex, I think, is the app. Hey, look at that. Now we've got a darker GTK theme. So I don't know. I don't think this would be very bad. Like I said earlier in the video, I've always felt that the distribution that you use is sort of the least important part. I mean, I know a lot of people trip about it. I think that's mainly just because there's like a million options and it's pretty overwhelming. Even if you're using a distribution that you've used for years and years and years and years and you know you like it, you know, there's always the thought of like, oh, well, is there something better? Look at that. Ubuntu, all beautiful and looking like Ubuntu instead of Arch. Here's what we want to do. One more thing here. We'll switch to Zeesh, because I'm sure that should be super easy to do as well. We'll find out here, eh? And then I could do, let's see here. Was it as change sudo change shell dash s or something? And I do user bin Zeesh to Mac, I think is how that works. And then if I exit and open up Tilex again. Ah, it worked. It worked. It definitely worked. I just went to ln-sf documents dot dot zeshenv here. And if my phone would shut up, that would make recording a video a lot easier. Exit, launch it again. And we need fortune. Sudo apt install fortune. And it's there, even under the right name and everything. ln-sf, gotta link up my fortune database here. Documents, dot, dot scripts. Put it right here in the old home folder. And look at that. It's looking good. Let's open up another window here. Tilex. Tilex, give me another one. Scale that down a bit. And then we just need to open up a file manager. And that is, I think, about as good as it can get. Keep in mind, PyCom and a few other things aren't working. That is entirely because of the virtual machine. So don't leave any weird comments about Ubuntu. I don't think anyone would. I think most of the people that commenting on my videos know way more about this than I do. But that is going to be it for this video. I'm pretty happy with this. So I think probably not for a little while. Probably I'll wait until I finish uploading every day in December. But pretty soon here, I think I'm going to try out switching to Ubuntu and see how that goes. Again, have never had an issue with Arch on my main machine. It's not a great OS for servers. I think a few people would argue with me about that. That's cool. I'm no expert in that regard, but I have found that if I am not constantly like on it about maintaining servers with Arch, there can be some issues updating down the line. And if that's the case on servers, I see no reason why that wouldn't be the case on a main production machine. And I do like to just sort of not ever turn off my main machine and let it run. So it is sort of effectively a server. Next time I build a new machine, I might as well just put EEC memory in it and build it with like a Xeon or Epic processor so that I can be better about just not turning the thing off ever. And hopefully I'll have a better solution rather than constantly rebooting to get into Windows to edit a video. Maybe by that point, there'll be an NLE for Linux that isn't terrible. But that, my friends, is going to be it for this particular video. Thank you, everybody, for watching, and check back here tomorrow for more Linux content, and I will see you in the next video.